Let's go to Phoenix, Arizona now, where we're joined by Turning Point Action official spokeswoman Caitlin Sinclair. Caitlin, thank you for joining us on Power Hour. First of all, we've just watched that train wreck interview with Kamala Harris on Fox News. What's your reaction to it?
Well, whoever encouraged Kamala Harris to do an interview with Fox News host Bret Baier, I want to personally send a thank you note to whoever that staffer was, because ultimately this interview has just ruined her entire campaign. I think every American should watch this interview with Kamala Harris and Bret Baier, and it will really show she cracked at the first non-softball interview that was in front of her. And these were not got-you questions, right? If every American watches this interview, Bret Baier was not trying to catch her in a I got you moment. These were policy questions. These were agenda questions. These were questions about the last 3.5 years of her administration questions. And she completely failed to answer any of them.
Well said. The U.S. Border Patrol Union, representing 16,000 members, has officially endorsed Donald Trump for president. Here is Border Patrol agent Paul Perez speaking about it.
If we allow Border Czar Harris to win this election, every city, every community in this great country is going to go to hell.
It's interesting, Caitlin. Kamala Harris couldn't really answer as to why the Border Patrol Union is endorsing Donald Trump and not Kamala Harris. But what impact will it make?
Yeah, kind of weird for the Border Czar when the Border Patrol Council and Union doesn't endorse her. Kind of weird, right? And I want to talk about the significance of this endorsement happening right here in the state of Arizona, where, of course, we've seen all of these crossings. Now, at this point in the administration, every state has turned into a border state, but there was such power and significance in this Border Patrol Council, all 16,000 members endorsing Donald Trump for president here in the state of Arizona. And of course, Kamala Harris was not the one to call families of Lake and Riley, Molly Tibbetts, Rachel Morin. Guess who was there for those young females that were killed at the hands of illegal immigrants due to Kamala Harris and Joe Biden? It was neither of them. It was Donald Trump. Donald Trump truly is the man that cares about females, that cares about a safe and secure border. And Kamala Harris, if you watch that interview, not only did she get angry, but she was actually screaming at the host when she was trying to blame Donald Trump for the policies that have existed under Joe Biden and her administration, and the host called her out for it.
Yeah, she couldn't keep her cool, could she? But on that point of Donald Trump supporting women's issues, we know that former U.S. President Donald Trump has vowed to keep trans-identifying men out of women's sports if he's elected. He made this pledge during a Fox News town hall in Georgia.
How do you plan on addressing the transgender issue in women's sports? I have 9 grandchildren, 6 of them female, wow, all playing sports. And we are very concerned for their safety, not just on the field and the courts, but in their locker rooms as well.
Right. It's such an easy question, and everybody in the room, and you know that answer. We're not going to let it happen.
Caitlin, it's a key issue for women in America, isn't it?
Absolutely. And while the left took the most wedge-dividing issue in this country and tried to make it the centerpiece of this entire campaign, which, of course, is the issue of abortion, there are real issues that matter to females. And I, as a young female, am sick of being wedged into this very narrow box. Does the left think that we're not capable of thinking outside of the box here? We only have one narrow way of thinking. Does the left think that women are so reduced to one single issue or
apparently
reduced to voting based on a gender? Because that's not the case with the millions of American women who are concerned about our safety and about the safety of our daughters, my future daughters, and Donald Trump's pledge right there really shows where he stands.
Well said. Look, President Biden, can you believe he's apparently still running the country? He's around and he's been speaking in Pennsylvania, and he seems to be holding on to hope that Donald Trump might be going to jail.
The same guy with 3 other major cases waiting for him when he loses. And by the way, 34 felonies. So far, he had good sentence. He got the sentence kicked back, but I want to watch that sentence. Look, Donald Trump's not running for you. He's running for himself. I think he's running to stay out of jail.
Still hard to make any sense of what he says.
Come on, man. Did Joe Biden just wake up from his nap time there? I mean, this is so pathetic on the part of Kamala Harris and her campaign that is trying to have Joe Biden, people like Bill Clinton, Barack Obama, come out of retirement. I know Joe Biden is still our sitting president. That's very hard for your viewers to even comprehend. But please, just stay in the White House, go to sleep, eat your ice cream, because having these people, again, like a Bill Clinton or Barack Obama on the campaign trail, is actually only hurting the Kamala Harris campaign and making Americans more aware of how there is no good Democrats that actually care about the American agenda.
Yeah, I think the more that Joe Biden speaks and Bill Clinton speaks, we're just seeing the support for Kamala Harris go down. It'll be interesting
more
to see what
Donald
happens.
More Trump ads, actually. More Donald
Trump ads.
Yeah, that's
true. He's just got so much material. But on Joe Biden, he spoke with Ukraine President Volodymyr Zelensky this week, discussing efforts to boost security aid to Ukraine. He's announced a new $425 million military aid package to Ukraine. What reaction can we expect the reaction to be from the American people when Americans are still recovering from Hurricane Helene and Milton with really minimal government assistance?
I think this outraged all Americans who heard this news today. Sending millions to Ukraine, sending $157 million to Lebanon recently, billions of dollars spent on welcoming illegals into this country, and yet we have American taxpaying citizens that are struggling, that just had their livelihoods wiped away by these two hurricanes. And what do they get? A lousy $750 and zero help from this administration. I think every American has every right to ask questions, demand answers, and be completely outraged. But how much longer are we going to let this go on? I hope every American out there is relating these disastrous decisions by the Biden administration to the minute they put that piece of paper in the ballot box, because they are absolutely correlated here. This is a result of the disastrous administration that keeps putting us into crises after crises, funding their elite agenda and proxy wars. And I think Americans are waking up, and we are quite frankly sick of it.